Hello dear patients, today we are going to review the case of phimosis, deposits and smell from glans penis. A young man came to us, he has reddening of glans penis, secondly he has a whitish deposit, it slightly resembles sperm on glans penis. Apart from that, if we open glans penis and it is shown on the picture, then a pit develops behind the glans penis. So a classic phimosis developed, when there is not enough skin for complete opening of glans penis, and during sex there are small ruptures, and this gradually turns into a vicious circle. Moreover, in this skin fold that does not open normally, conditions for persistence of candida fungus develop, conditions for persistence of different bacteria develop. So, in this case, often a reddening of glans penis and foreskin develop, as in our case. What needs to be done? First of all, during reddening, we need to check for diabetes mellitus, for allergy, for fungus, to do culture tests for bacteria and culture tests for fungus, as well as extended PCR analysis for fungus, and to check for other infections, such as gardnerella or others, if the patient wants it. This is a minimal complex that needs to be done. Here we found a usual candida albicans and fecal enterococcus in bacterial culture test. We recommended such patient to do circumcision, however not all patients are ready for it, particularly at an adult age, so many patients delayed. Here a development of paraphimosis is possible. You can watch a separate video on our channel about paraphimosis. It includes clinical case as well. This is an impingement of foreskin, then of glans penis, down to its necrosis. That's what it's bad for. In this case a classic treatment of candida was prescribed. By the way, in culture test enterococcus from urethra was found. That is, there was a bacterial urethritis. No candida was found in urethra, however, there is a constant penetration of it there, and in this case enterococcus has to be treated, and urethritis has to be treated. Not only an inflammation of glans penis, so not only ointments, but instillations have to be used, as well as general antibiotics according to sensitivity, and enzymes by type of longidaza. Anti-inflammatory measures have to be used as well, such as baths with furoscilline. They have to be used in parallel by the patients. General antifungal medications have to be used, again, according to sensitivity, as today even candida albicans often acquires atypical sensitivity. However, in this case there was a sensitivity to ketoconazole, that is quite a widely used medication. Unfortunately, in tablet form it's quite often unavailable today, and therefore ointment with ketoconazole was used by type of nizoral. We also used ketoconazole in tablets in addition to the treatment by longidaza together with antibiotic. So gradually, within 2 weeks, this process resolved. Control analysis showed negative candida and enterococcus. Such analysis also have to be done by a constant partner. In this case, this is a girlfriend, not a wife, in whom candida was found, and it was treated by gynecologist of our clinic. The main thing here is to understand that one of the main predisposing factors is phimosis, which creates a background for persistence and multiplication of such bacteria and fungi. Later on they can induce inflammation of prostate. This can happen, as during prostatitis we often find enterococci as well. So the best treatment here, together with the one described above, is circumcision. If it's necessary to diagnose and treat different lesions of glans penis skin, as well as lesions of urethra of infectious and non-infectious origins, you can consult urologists and venerologists of our paid medical center of dermatovenerologic dispensary in Moscow. We have experienced specialists who do diagnostics and treatment of such diseases. We are waiting for you in our clinic.